in Raj Niwas, we use the word Team Raj Niwas. I don't say I. Now, in Team Raj Niwas, there are everybody who's play all kinds of roles, including the one who ensures we get right nutrition. And now let's come to the schools. The point here is, earlier, inclusivity on schools was limited to disability, physical only. But dramatically, things have changed. It's now about everybody, every child, according to his or her need. Every child is unique. You may not see a physical disability, but you see a very angry child. The child may look all right, appears all right, but is an angry child and is breaking things or is shouting. Now this child's need is different. So how do you make it inclusive? Which means the teachers, not just the teacher, it's the teachers who have to work on that child. Every teacher is a tailor. Now the challenge is not the policy, the challenge is retraining the current teachers on being individualized in their education. Rather than being only competitive, trained to be collaborative. Our teachers are only teaching competition, full marks at cutthroat. First of all, inclusion is in the family. Let's begin from home. The spirit of sharing. How much is the giving happening? Who's sharing with what? With whatever you have. First my brother, first my sister, first my somebody who's got a greater need. That to me is very inclusive. But with single child norms, even I'm just one child mother, I think we are denying our single children from sharing. So where does our child learn inclusivity and sharing and giving? In schools. But in classes, if you're constantly being trained to beat others, score over the others, and not team building, and not giving, and not mutual learning, you will not teach them. Since we're talking about inclusivity, one of the methods of inclusivity is group learning, where each other teaches the other. So the more inclusive activities we have, we'll train inclusivity, and then also mutual learning.